Hello, my dear students. After a long time, I am here. Your subject teacher, Mr. Hemo Singh. Due to coronavirus, the whole country is locked down, so we cannot have a regular classes. But we have to find an alternative sources. So now we are representing the classes through online with the help of this next. I hope you will enjoy. So let us start our new topic, that is current electricity.
Students, today we will start a new topic that is more interesting topic, that is current electricity. You have already studied in first unit, that is electric charges at trace, that is we call as electrostatics. Here we will study about current electricity. So let us define what is current electricity. The study of electric charges in motion is called current electricity. Let me repeat again what we are going to study in this unit. The study of electric charges in motion is called current electricity. When electric charges in motion, then they produce electric current. So what is electric current? The flow of electric charges through a conductor constitute an electric current. In another way, we can define as, it is defined as the amount of charge flowing across that area per unit time. The amount of charge flowing across that per unit time is also called as electric current. If a charge del Q passes through in time t to t plus del t, then the current I at any time is given by I is equal to limit del t tends to 0 del Q by del t is equal to dQ by dt. If the current is steady, let me repeat again, if the current is steady, that is if the charges are moving with constant velocity, that is the rate of flow of charge does not change with time, then we can define as I equal to Q upon T, where I stands for electric current and Q stands for electric charge and T is the time taken. But according to quantization of charges, this Q can be written as Q is equal to Ne, where N is the number of electrons and E is the electronic charge. After substituting this Q in this equation, I become as I equal to Ne upon T. Its SI unit is ampere. 1 ampere equal to 1 coulomb per second. If 1 coulomb of charge crosses an area in 1 second, then the current through that area is 1 ampere. It is a scalar quantity. You know that electric current has both magnitude and direction, but it does not obey the triangle law of vector addition. So that's why the electric current is considered as scalar quantity. Conventional direction of electric current. The conventional direction of electric current is from positive charge to negative charge. Let me repeat again. The conventional direction of electric current is from positive to negative charge, but it is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons, that is electronic current. Let me explain in detail. When a conductor is connected through a cell or battery. Electrons starts moving from negative terminal of a battery to positive terminal, but positive charges are moving from positive terminal of the battery to negative. By conventionally, the direction of electric current is considered only by the flow of positive charge, but it is opposite to the direction of flow of electrons. Now let me define a new device that is called ammeter. An ammeter is a device which is used to measure an electric current in a circuit. So what we are going to define, what is an ammeter? An ammeter is a device which is used to measure an electric current in a circuit. It is always connected in series. You have to note down this point. An ammeter is always connected in series in a electric circuit. The symbolic form of ammeter is A. Sometimes it may write micro ammeter or maybe milli ammeter or simply A. It has two terminals, positive and negative. Next, let us go to the next device, that is voltmeter. A voltmeter is a device which is used to measure potential difference across the ends of a conductor. It is always connected in parallel in a circuit. Let me repeat again. A voltmeter is a device which is used to measure potential difference across the ends of a conductor. It is always connected in parallel in a circuit. You can see here in this simple circuit diagram, a voltmeter is connected in parallel with a resistance R. It has two terminals, positive and negative terminal.